Welcome to Monday with Michelle and Out Late But Great. And as promised, today we are going to draw the name out of the hat. And we're going to pick a prize for the Out Late But Great mug. So my lovely assistant is filming. And if you can show in the hat. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, these are all. Okay, now show me. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the hat over here on the piano. So there's no way I can see any of these crumbled papers. All right, ready?
Ready.
Okay. This one is by a YouTuber called The Gender Fool. And I'm not sure if that who that is. So they're the ones that won the prize. And the question was reincarnation. Are transgender people just following a path from a past life? And there it is, right there. So, Gender Fool, if you are watching, I don't want to email you because I don't want to surprise you, so I'm going to give you an entire day. So, if you're watching this, you have our email address. Email me at outlapagreat@yahoo.com. And I'll make the arrangements to get your mug off to you. And so let's get on with our other topic today. So there you saw it, our winner. And I'm sorry if I sounded a little confusing. What I said is I didn't want to email this person and ruin the surprise by them seeing their name picked on the video. So if the person who won does not contact me in the next day, then I will contact them at the end of Tuesday. But there you go. And so for the rest of you who did not win, I'm sorry. And there's always next time. And all of your great topics are going to go on to our topic list. And whenever we do any of your topics, as you know, I will always contact you and see if you want to be a guest vlogger. So there we go. All right, so Maya had the topic this week in addition to announcing the winner. And she wants to know, has being LGBT impacted on your spirituality or belief systems? I really like this topic. Many of you know I quit my church job last year because I just started feeling like I could not pour my blood, sweat, and tears into an organization that did not support me and was not progressively moving forward. I apologize if I'm a little hoarse. I've been fighting some crud all weekend, and actually yesterday had to call out sick on a job that I was hired to do, and I felt terrible about it. I woke up and I could not sing, and it was just like a once a year type thing, and you know, it just happened to be the day that I had to do this is when I lost my voice, so I still feel really crappy about that. So anyway, back to our topic. When I was growing up, you know, I grew up Catholic, and I never really saw anything that was negative towards the LGBT community. Of course, I was a kid, so I wasn't really plugged in. Some kids might be, but I wasn't, especially back in the early 70s. It just wasn't really talked about. The only thing I ever heard about anybody gay was knowing that I had a gay Uncle Chester and then gay cousins. So it was like, but it wasn't a negative thing. It's just like, you know, they happen to be gay. So when I was about 13, 14, I left the Catholic Church and explored within the realm of Christianity. And just, I don't know, I just kept feeling like this was not speaking to me. And I lost a lot of faith in church. Now, not in the people that were genuine Christians who really walked the walk, etc. But I lost my faith in the church when I saw a lot of hypocrisy, especially when I saw a lot of hypocrisy in the higher ups of churches that I used to attend. And then once you work in a church, you get a completely different perspective on churches. Now, I want to say though that everybody at the church that I worked for 18 years, no one ever disrespected me, and everybody was always super nice to me, and I was treated very well there. My choice to leave was, you know, for a few reasons. One, that my my teaching was expanding. I was playing more concerts, and I just wanted to go to a general direction with my life, and I didn't want to have a church job anymore. And compiled on top of that, having, you know, this whole thing happen where they were not progressing with the rest of the, you know, churches, especially within the Episcopal Church. So I know I went off on a little bit of a tangent there, but as far as has being LGBT affected my spirituality, yes, it definitely has. Because when I was coming out 8 years ago, I was in a really, really, really low place. Seriously low place. And with the help of reading spiritual books, not religious books, but spiritual books, I was able to really pull out of that funk and then finally able to come out of the closet and then really develop my path spiritually. Ever since I left the Catholic Church, I always kind of went on a road less traveled type of spiritual path. And just now, in the last 10 years, I feel like I'm really coming into the path that speaks for me and my Native American beliefs and background has a lot to do with that. So yeah, it really helped to being LGBT really helped guide me into more of a spiritual place because I had to really dig deep in order not to become super depressed about my situation and what I had to do. And also some self-help books that really had nothing to do with spirituality, but some self-help books like Louise Hay, You Can Heal Your Life. That was a lifesaver for me. And yeah, I think just going deeper into your own thoughts and into your own heart really awakens your spirituality, and most of the time that has really nothing to do with the religion that you are. And there is a difference, and I know a lot of people feel that way too. All right, so I'm going to let my voice rest now because I have to teach two lessons before I have to go play, and I'm already feeling kind of run down, so I don't know how I'm going to pull this off, but I'm going to try. And I hope that you guys have a really good week. Are any of you doing Vlogmas where you vlog every day for December? If you want to, if you're at all remotely interested, I'm doing it on my personal channel, and which is Paintedravensong. And I'm incorporating some of my piano playing into my vlogs and cooking and stuff like that. So if any of you are remotely interested, you can, you know, head over. I'll put the link in the description box below. All right, you all have a great week, and congratulations again to the Gender Fool who won our contest. I will need you to contact me with your name and address so I know where to send the mug, and then we'll talk further in email about you being a guest. Thank you so much. Peace.